can be said that the universe of Tron revolves mostly around the activity of its human users. The programs found in the digital world often play a critical role in the outworking of events. In this video, I'd like to talk about the history of Tron, the most famous program to be loaded on the grid, and the legacy he left as a relentless warrior who fought for the users. Tron is a self-monitoring security program created by Alan Bradley, a programmer employed by the American Multinational Computer Technology Corporation, ENCOM. Alan continued working on the Tron prototype until he discovered that his access to the ENCOM system had been suspended. This suspension was the result of a security measure taken by senior executive Edward Dillinger to lock out Kevin Flynn, a hacker who was trying to expose Dillinger's nefarious deeds. During this time, inside the system, Bradley's Tron program, which mirrored his resemblance, was taken captive by the MCP, a rogue program serving as system administrator. To assist the administrator, another one of Dillinger's creations, Sark, served as the commander of the MCP's army and overseer of the games fought on the games grid. After his capture, Sark forced Tron to participate in gladiatorial games on the grid. As a security program, Tron possessed formidable combat skills, proving himself quite capable, achieving victory in the games even when pitted against multiple opponents. Through his time in the arena, Tron gained the reputation of being a program who fought for the users. In a failed attempt to regain access to Tron, Alan Bradley met with Dillinger and explained his program's capabilities, suggesting that it could serve as a watchdog for the MCP. Unbeknownst to Alan, the MCP had already spoken out against the development of the Tron program, as it would only work to combat the system administrator's illegal activities. Alan and his girlfriend Laura then conspired with Kevin Flynn to break into ENCOM and grant Bradley the ability to unleash his Tron program, which could shut down the MCP and release the evidence needed to expose Dillinger. As this plan was carried out, the MCP recognized Flynn at Laura's terminal and used her digitizing laser to transfer the user into the ENCOM system. Flynn was then captured and sent to fight on the game grid, where Tron was also being held. Tron was taken aback when Flynn called the program by his user's name, but Flynn, then realizing who Tron was, claimed to be a fellow program similarly tasked with destroying the MCP. Tron and Flynn, along with a fellow combatant, Ram, were then loaded onto the Light Cycle grid, where they went up against three programs from Sark's army. Tron forced one of the programs to crash into a wall of the game grid, opening up a fissure through which they could escape. In order to erase the MCP and change the system, Tron needed data from his user Alan to be encoded on his identity disk. To accomplish this, the program would need to access an input-output tower. The trio were separated shortly after an attack by an enemy tank, and presuming his friends to have been derezzed, Tron continued on to the tower. He first made a detour to free Yori, a program created by Laura, who had connections with a tower guardian named Dumont. Dumont allowed Tron the time required to communicate with his user. After acquiring the information he needed, Yori and Tron made their way to confront the MCP on a solar sailor bound for the heart of the ENCOM system. As they made their journey, they ran into Flynn, who then revealed his true status as a user. Tron assumed that, as a user, Flynn would have some grand plan, but was disconcerted to learn of the user's lack of control within the system. After Commander Sark crashed his carrier into the solar sailor, Tron was cut off from Yori and Flynn. He survived by clinging to the outside of the carrier as it made its way to the mesa of the MCP. Sark was then sent to confront Tron, culminating in a disc battle between the two. After Sark's initial defeat, the MCP channeled all of his functions into reviving the fallen commander in an attempt to stop Tron's advance. In the meantime, Flynn was able to disorient both the MCP and the resurrected Sark long enough for Tron to cast his disc through the shields and de-res the MCP. After the destruction of the MCP, the system was restored and subsequently freed from any tyrannical oppression. In the years that followed, Tron would see several upgrades. His data was eventually copied over to Flynn's personal server, where he was tasked to oversee the security of the grid, Kevin's newly built digital frontier. Flynn also recreated his old hacking program, Clue, to continue working as system administrator in his absence. Tron, Clue, and Flynn worked together in developing and securing the infrastructure of the grid, and all three were present for the first appearance of the isomorphic algorithms. The manifestation of the ISOs proved to be a divisive event, as Flynn viewed them to be a miracle, however Clue saw them only as a threat. Clue sought to destroy these beings through the creation of the Abraxas virus. To fight against Abraxas, Tron worked with a prototype system monitor program named Anon. Tron decided that it was too dangerous for Flynn to remain in the system. While on their way to the portal, the two were attacked by Clue and his Black Guard, forcing Tron to draw their attention, allowing Flynn to escape. Severely damaged from Clue's attack, Tron was kept alive, and his code was further degraded as he was tortured by his former friend Dyson in an attempt to get him to serve Clue willingly. After garnering sympathy from a guard named Cyrus, Tron was allowed to escape into hiding after the recognizer carrying him crashed in the Outlands. Because Tron's injuries prevented him from taking action, he began to train a young program named Beck, who he intended to serve as his replacement as the new protector of the grid. Over time, Tron's desire for retribution grew, and he began to neglect himself, resulting in his injuries worsening. Tron eventually set off to exact his revenge on Dyson, but he ultimately spared the traitor's life, allowing him to deliver a single message to Clue. Tron lives. Eventually, Tron would be recaptured, repurposed, and renamed Rinzler. Wielding twin identity disks, Rinzler served as Clue's primary enforcer, and regularly appeared as the final opponent for programs forced to fight in the games. Although he was repurposed, Rinzler retained Tron's relentless nature, as well as his superior combat, driving, and piloting skills. Although much of his old personality had been stripped away, remnants of his former memories persisted. While in pursuit of Cora, Flynn, and his son Sam, Rinzler briefly came face to face with Kevin, triggering the degradation of Clue's reprogramming. Rinzler began to experience flashbacks and became disoriented. After he realized his true identity, Tron stated his determination to fight for the users once more, and piloted his light jet into Clue's, destroying both vehicles. This maneuver left the two falling over the sea of simulation. Clue was successful in wrestling away the only spare light jet baton, leaving Tron to fall into the sea. As he sank, his restoration appeared to complete as his circuitry blinked out before reactivating with its original white glow. While the first two Tron films have centered around the activity of the Flynns, it is ultimately Tron who stands out as a beacon of loyalty, determination, and selflessness. Tron consistently proved himself willing to do anything for the users, and showed an unwavering resolve in his work to protect the users and achieve freedom for his fellow programs. For these qualities, in my opinion, it's quite fitting for the entire franchise to bear his name. But I'm curious to know what you think about Tron. Is there a moment from this program's history that stands out as your favorite? Do you expect to see more from this character as the franchise moves forward? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, and be sure to subscribe for more Tron and other sci-fi and fantasy news and lore. Thank you all so much for your support, and as always, have a very nerdy day.